Results Grid is a tool that allows you to navigate through a results set received from a SQL server after executing a valid query. The results are displayed below the query window. Each query window has its own results grid, so switching different query windows does not erase the results. However, every new execution of the query immediately resets results grid. If you make a mistake, the query will not return any data. Instead, you will see the Messages tab with the description of your error. If the query is composed correctly, SQL Server will return the requested data to results grid. It consists of columns with headers and cells that contain the actual data stored in a SQL table. If your query returns several result sets, they will be shown in separate grids. To hide results pane, press Ctrl plus R. The same combination invokes the pane back. Now let's review some non-obvious peculiarities. By default, results pane consists of two tabs, results grid and messages tab. Query can return messages in messages tab. So if you are working with stored procedures that return messages and result sets, make sure that you check messages tab. Result sets can be very massive, but you cannot search within results grid using regular SSMS functionality. This problem, however, can be solved with the help of SSMSBoost add-in. You cannot sort data in results grid. Sorting should be done in advance, by means of a corresponding SQL query. Use order by clause when constructing your query. You can move columns to change order within results set by dragging and dropping column headers. This can be useful when you analyze the data and need to have some specific columns close to each other. You can see the number of returned rows in the right corner of status bar. Note that if your query returns multiple result sets, SSMS will display the total number of rows in all grids. To see the number of rows in a particular grid, make it active with a left mouse click. If you work with queries that return huge amounts of data, SSMS, your server and network can be excessively loaded. To prevent this, you can predefine the maximum number of characters returned per cell. Go to Tools, Options, Query Results, Results to Grid, and change the maximum characters retrieved value. Note that settings will only be applied to newly created query windows. Press Ctrl plus N to make the setting relevant. Data in cells is always truncated. There is no way to set it unlimited. Though it is possible to get full data from the cell using SSMSBoost add-in. You can select the desired rows and columns with your mouse or select all data using Ctrl plus A combination. To get only the data, right-click Results grid and choose Copy. Or copy with headers if you want to get data with corresponding column headers. The data is now copied to clipboard as plain text and can be pasted wherever you need. Apart from regular data selection, you can do selection by blocks. Once you have selected the first set of values, hold down Ctrl key and proceed to the next block. Repeat this action till you have selected all the data you need. Blocks will be copied to clipboard in the exact same order that you selected them, and can be pasted to any text editor. You can copy-paste data to Excel, but be careful with copying across different regional settings, like decimal values and dates, as data is copied in text form. To have column headers copied together with data in rows by default, you should enable this function in Tools, Options, Query Results, Results to Grid. It is possible to export the entire grid to text or CSV file. Right-click Results Grid in any place and choose Save Results As. The result will be saved in the chosen text-based format. SSMS keeps the history of query execution benchmarks and allows you to measure and analyze query performance over time. To take advantage of this function, click Query, Include Client Statistics. Now, when you execute your query, the Client Statistics tab will appear on Results pane. It keeps track of query performance and displays statistics history. You can reset statistics using the menu command Reset Client Statistics. Execution plan draws a visual query execution scheme. To see it, go to Query, Display Estimated Execution Plan. The analysis of this scheme is a separate topic that requires a lot of explanation. We will not cover it now. Just remember that execution plan can help you analyze inefficient queries and detect badly designed tables or indexes. The built-in results grid functionality in SSMS is quite basic. SSMSBoost drastically improves it by adding many useful features, like search for columns and values, export data to Excel, preserving all metadata, copy headers, and a lot of other handy stuff. Check out our SSMSBoost tutorial videos to learn more about these functions. That is all for today. I hope the tips will help you perform faster and better than you did before. If you want to learn how to work with SSMS Results Grid more effectively, check out our videos about SSMSBoost add-in. Don't forget to share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.